Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Sir Jude, and today I am recapping Charles Law. So remember when we were discussing Charles Law way back a month ago, this was the last lesson na kung saan naka 1 hour per period pa tayo because hindi po gaano mainit that time. And also remember na this is when I asked you to perform an experiment na kung saan papalobohin nyo palalo yung inflated balloon sa kumukulong tubig na hiniram po sa co-teacher ko. Tapos, after yung pakuluan, in-expect nyong mas lumaki lalo yung volume. And then, nung nilagay natin sa beaker na malamig ang tubig, and then, nag-shrink. So, according to Jacques Charles, in his law, T, or temperature, is directly proportional to V, or volume at constant pressure. So, in mathematics, when you say directly proportional, pag may isang variable na tumataas or increasing, the other variable also increases, tumataas. Or, pag may isang variable na bumababa yung value, decreasing, the other variable also decreases, bababa rin yung kanyang value. This time, ang constant natin ay C, pressure. Now, so let's tackle the two principles of Charles Law. So based on the relationship between temperature and volume at constant pressure, we can derive that when there's higher temperature, there's also high volume. And when there's low temperature, there's also low volume. So our first set of scenario is the hot air balloon. So when you ignite the flame of the hot air balloon, so the volume of the hot air balloon expands or increases, allowing it to float in the air. No, kaya nga siya lumulutang. And because of that, this is an offshoot of high temperature and high volume. On the other hand, when you want to go down the hot air balloon, I mean go down as in pababa na kayo sa ground or lupa, you have to extinguish the flame of the hot air balloon. And because of that, the volume of the hot air balloon will start to shrink. So that is a consequence of lower temperature and lower volume as well. Now, second set of example. So you have a deodorant bottle standing at room temperature. Karamihan sa mga personal garments natin na for hygiene, no? Nakapaton lang sa table and then it is surrounded in a room with the room temperature. So, room temperature meaning temperature ranging from 25 to 30 degrees Celsius. So, you also have a deodorant bottle exploding beside the handle. Yung makikita nyo sa kanan, dito yung Dove deodorant bottle na sumabog because nilagay malapit sa nakasinding kanila. So, judging between the two, the deodorant bottle standing at room temperature has low temperature. So therefore, mame-maintain yung volume niya. Mas mababa yung volume niya compared sa deodorant bottle exploding beside a candle. So dahil nakalanghap or naka-absorb ng heat from the candle, then therefore, nag-expand yung volume ng deodorant bottle and then it exploded. So those are just some of the practical applications of Charles Law. Let's move over to the mathematical relationship between volume and temperature at constant pressure. So, we use the formula. This is a new formula compared to Boyle's law. V1 times T2 equals V2 times T1. So, what are now the four variables na involved sa Charles law? And ano yung kanilang standard unit? Let's start with V1. V1 stands for initial volume. Its standard unit is liter, represented by capital letter L. V2 stands for final volume with the standard unit of, also a standard unit of liter, represented by capital letter L. T1 refers to initial temperature with the standard unit of Kelvin, while T2 refers to final temperature with a standard unit of Kelvin as well. So, for those of you who are confused, alam ko na we do not use Kelvin most of the time in our normal temperature readings. we have been accustomed to degrees Celsius and degrees Fahrenheit. But sa calculations kasi ng Charles Law, we must express all temperature values in Kelvin because it is the standard unit. However, for the purposes of this discussion and to make the calculations and substitutions easier, I decided to convert, the given values of temperature already converted to Kelvin. So no need to convert anymore. Now, of the four variables that I just presented to you, ano-ano yung mga, yung dalawang isasolve natin. Okay. So, first will be V2. So, how do we solve for V2? So, let me rewrite the formula first. So, you have V1 times T2 equals V2 times T1. On the right side, magkasama si V2 at saka si T1. And we need to isolate V2, so we have to divide both sides of the equation by T1. And because of that, the T1 on the right side will be cancelled, leaving us with V2 equals V1 times T2 divided by T1. That's one of the formula that we're going to use later in one of our sample problems. Now, the other variable that we have to solve is T2. So just like what we did a while ago, let me copy the formula first. Ngayon, the two variables that are joined together by multiplication is V1 and T2. Since we're concerned with T2, we have to isolate V1 by virtue of division. So we have to divide both sides of the equation by V1. And because of that, to solve for T2, we use the formula V2 times T1 divided by V1. Oh, I almost forgot. Cancel na dito pala si V1 sa left side of the equation. Now, with two of our required variables already manipulated in the formula, let's solve some sample problems. Okay. Sample problem number one. A tausig mother cooked dulang, amount of rice with fish and vegetables and rice cakes around it for her daughter's birthday. The cake rose to 0.1 liter when baked at 596 Kelvin. However, the daughter arrived late and the cake shrunk at room temperature, which is 298 Kelvin. What was its new volume? In problem solving, the first thing that we do is we list the given values. Or rather, we label them. So 0.1 liter is the first volume given, so that will serve as V1. 596 Kelvin is the first temperature given, this will be T1. 298 Kelvin is the second temperature given, so this is T2. Now, because we're being asked to find for new volume or V2, then therefore, our point of interest is V2. So, according from the previous slide, to solve for V2, the formula that we're going to use is V1 times T2 divided by T1. To substitute the values for our solution, we have V2 equals our V1 is 0.1 liter. Our T2 is 298 Kelvin. And our T1 is 596 Kelvin. Ayan. So try substituting them in your scientific calculators or on your cell phone. So the answer or the new volume will be 0.05 liters. So let's analyze the comparison of the initial and final values to check if what we did adheres to Charles' law. Okay? So V1. Nung bagong bake pa lang yung cake, ang volume niya is 0.1 liter. at a temperature of, ito po, at a temperature of 596 Kelvin. Ngayon, late umuwi yung anak, therefore lumamig yung cake. So si cake nag-shrunk at 0.05 liters yung makasolve lang natin. Kasi yung temperature niya from 596 Kelvin naging 298 Kelvin na lang. So, between the two values of volume, 0.1 naging 0.05 liters. So, volume decreased. T1, 596 to T2, 298 Kelvin. Bumaba rin si temperature. So, this follows Charles' law because volume and temperature exhibited their proportional relationship. Yun nga lang, bumaba si volume, or rather, bumaba si temperature, therefore, nag-decrease din ang volume. Now, wala na questions, and kung clear na lahat, let's proceed to sample problem number 2. Okay. Pasensya na po, o medyo mahaba yung problem. Let's analyze it, the sentences one by one. A Muslim teacher trains his students for an upcoming ping pong competition. On one occasion, one of his students accidentally strikes the ball at a scorching room temperature of 298 Kelvin, deflating it to 0.01 meter. So, napisa yung ping pong ball. If he wants to inflate it back to 0.012 liters, at what temperature must he hit it? So, if you have no idea, every time na may mapipisa ang ping pong ball, ang ginagawa ng mga sports, rather ng mga tawag dito, PE coaches or ping pong coach, is papakuluan lang nila yung napisang ping pong ball hanggang sa bumalik sa dating anyo. Ngayon, let's label our given values. So, 298 Kelvin is the first temperature given. Kaya, this will be T1. 0.01 liter is the first volume given. So, that is V1. Next, 0.012 liters is the final volume given. So, that's V2. And because we're being asked for the new temperature, then therefore, the one that's being required to solve is, T2. Ayan. So, what equation are we going to use to solve for T2? So, to solve for T2, we use the formula V2 times T1. Divided by P1. Substituting the values for our solution, we have T2 equals 0.012 liter times T1, 298 Kelvin, divided by the initial volume, 0.01 liter. So, substitute the values in your scientific calculator. Be careful po with typing the numbers. Baka po magkamali sa decimal places, magkamali ng pindot ng number, mamali po ng sagot. And this solution will give you a new temperature of 357.6 Kelvin. Now, to check whether our answer followed Charles' law, we have to make our volume temperature comparisons. So, our initial temperature is 0.01 liter. Our final temperature is 357. Sorry, mali pala ako ng sulat. Ayan. All right, let's redo. So our initial temperature is our T1 is 298 Kelvin, and our T2, the one that we just solved, is 357.6 Kelvin. Now, the initial volume of the ping pong ball is 0.01 liter, and the final volume of the ping pong ball is 0.012 liter. So temperature, 298 naging 357.6 uminit at tumaas ang temperature. In volume, 0.01 naging 0.012, lumapad, lumawak. So therefore, tumaas yung value ng volume. So, in this scenario, temperature and volume exhibits direct proportional relationship under constant pressure. Alang, when temperature rises, volume also of the ping pong ball rises. So, bilang po for Charles Law, you may research some sample problems that look for either V2 or T2. And then, ingat lang po sa pag-label ng given values para hindi po bumali ng pag-substitute sa problem solving. Now, since we're technically done, it's time to have our recap. Okay. Number one, which letter represents the mathematical formula of Charles' Law? So remembering Charles' Law, ang kinocompare natin is volume and temperature. That makes A and B already incorrect. So we're left with letter T. V1 times T2 equals T2 times T1. Number two, which two properties of gas are compared in Charles' Law? So na bang sabi ko na yung sagot kanina in number one, that's temperature and volume, letter C, T and V. Number three, which property of gas remains constant in Charles' Law? So the one that we never solved at all is pressure, letter A, represented by capital letter P. Number four, what will happen to the volume of a gas if its T is increased at constant P? So when temperature increases, so tumaas yung isang value, tataas din dapat yung value ni volume. So letter A. Number five, what will happen to the volume of a gas if its temperature is decreased at constant pressure? So bumaba yung value ng isang variable, therefore bababa rin yung value ng isang variable. Decreases, letter B. Number six, if the temperature of a gas is decreased by 8 times the original, what will happen to its volume at constant pressure? So if lumamig by 8 times the original temperature yung system, then therefore, liliit or magde-decrease din yung volume ng system by 8 times the original. Number 7. If the temperature of a gas is increased by 5 times the original, what will happen to its volume at constant pressure? So, pinainit natin yung gas sa temperature 5 times the original. Therefore, yung volume niya mag-expand din, mag-increase din by 5 times the original. Number eight, what kind of proportionality exists between volume and temperature at constant P? Pag bumaba si temperature, sorry, pag tumaas si temperature, tataas din si volume. Pag bumaba si temperature, bababa rin si volume. That's a direct proportional relationship. Number nine, which graph correctly depicts the relationship between volume and temperature at constant T? So, the correct answer here is letter C. Bakit letter C? Because if you start at the bottom of the graph, mababa si temperature, mababa din si volume. And once you reach the top of the graph, or the line rather, mataas si temperature, mataas din si volume. So, pinapakita yung direct proportional relationship nila. Now, numbers 10 to 15. Because tapos na tayo sa Boyle's and Charles' Law, I want you to determine the gas to apply in each scenario. So, ganito lang yan. Pag pressure and volume, Sorry, pag Boyle's law, hindi involved si temperature at all. Walang umiinit, walang lalamig. Pero pag Charles law, since involved si temperature, papasok dito yung concept ng init at saka lamig. So, halimbawa, number 10, scuba diving. Nahihirapan ka huminga pag nasa baba ka na ng malapit ka sa floor ng dagat kaysa kapag malapit ka sa surface. So, hindi factor si temperature dito. This is Boyle's law. 11, baking pastries. Ayan, pinapainit ang pastry sa oven. So therefore, nag-expand kapag tapos na manuto. This is Charles Law. Number 12, blood donation. Pag blood donation, pinipisil natin yung bag or rather, kumukuha tayo ng blood sa patient or nag-inject tayo ng blood sa patient using syringe or a bag. And since hindi naman involved ang temperature dito, therefore this is an application of Boyle's law. Number 13, hot air balloons. Pag sinindahan mo yung fire, mag-expand yung balloon. Pag hinihinaan mo yung apoy, liliit din yung size ng balloon. So because fire is involved or heat is involved, then therefore that's an application of Charles' law. Number 14, microwaving food. Just like in baking pastries, we're using oven here. In microwaving food, inaalaw natin yung kinetic energy ng heated gas molecules to enter inside the food para mag-expand. And because heat is involved, this is an application of Charles' law. Last item, inhalation and exhalation, or simply breathing, no? Nagbabago yung size ng lungs natin. So, no heat is applied. That's why we have Boyle's law. And that's it for the two gas laws. I hope na na-refresh na kayo sa concepts natin and problem solving about Charles' law. Just remember, just always go back to the principle that was mentioned by Robert Boyle and Jacques Charles. And you don't need to memorize the formula because it will be given to you. So just analyze the problem, label the given values, and be careful in substitution and typing the numbers in your calculator. And tawag dito, dadalian na lang kayo sa topic na ito. That's all for Charles Law. And on my next video, tatakal naman natin ang three macromolecules of life. Goodbye.